Hey there, measurement ladies and gentlemen. Are you afraid of anomalies? Well, you shouldn't be, because it's really easy to detect those in GA4. So let's have a look at it together. So what is anomaly? This is something that deviates from what is standard, normal, or expected. In other words, these are some outliers in your data. For example, you could have an unexpected spike of users or transaction on your website. Or this could be the opposite, a sudden decrease in your traffic on a specific day of the week. Or you could identify some web pages with an unusually low conversion rate comparing to other pages. And this is kind of an issue you have to fix. So in this way, you can spot some abnormal patterns in your data that have an underlying value to your business. And in this way, you can mitigate any possible damage as well as grasp the opportunities out there. So we also have to look on the bright side, and I will show you an example later. Let me provide you some examples. Let's say you implemented tracking and you spotted the anomaly, and in such way you can understand, oh, there is a technical issue on this page and I have to fix it. Or you run your own e-commerce store and you want to follow the trends and to understand what products are in demand right now. So this is also a way to do it. But how can you achieve this goal in GA4 to check anomalies? Okay, so I'm working with the demo account and I also have my own account. And here, if I go to reports, you can see some insights. So the first way to identify anomaly in GA4 is to use insights. So Google has been heavily investing in machine learning, and this is a result. So you can quickly identify those outliers, and this definitely saves you time. So Google gives you some hints about some spikes or decreases, and in this way, you can identify issues or opportunities for your website or your application and find the crux of the problem in a quick way. So if you click view all insights, here you can see, for example, users spiked. So what's the reason that they spiked on this specific day? Or you could also see that transactions spiked. So maybe you launched a campaign and it turned out to be super successful, and it's a way for you to grasp this opportunity and to engage even more people. Well, for example, organic search appeared in 72.96% of your conversion paths. So what could be the reason? And in this way, you can gain some valuable insights for your business. And by answering those questions and finding the reasons, you can improve your business strategy and generate even more revenue as a result, right? Sounds good. So how can we do that in GA4? I'm using the demo account right now. This is why I don't have this option here. But if I go to my own account, you can see that you can also create your own insights. So you can see how much flexibility GA4 gives you. So let's click create. And in this way, you can use suggested custom insights, and you can check and uncheck the ones you need or do not need. And you can also review them here. So provide some conditions that you need for your specific case. Or you can start from scratch and define your own custom insights. Sounds pretty cool. So if you click create new, this is where you can create your own insights. And here, evaluation frequency, you can choose the one you need, and hourly is available for web only. If we check Google documentation, so you can read that for custom insights for app events are unavailable at this time. But if you're interested in hourly custom insights for app events, you can complete this form. So Google kind of is willing to negotiate this with you. But let's go back here. And this is where you can also define your own segment you want to look at. For example, you could use all users, or you could look at a specific subset of your data. So let's say I want to look at my users who come from Poland. So this is where you provide the conditions, and who have the operating system Windows, just as an example. and you would click apply. And in this way, you would create the segment you would love to have a look at. But let me choose all users. This is where you provide the metric. Yeah, so you can select anything from this list. Let's say user engagement. And this is where you specify your condition. For example, has anomaly, but you could go even a step further and you could customize it even more, providing your own value, right? So you could choose any of those options. And of course, you should provide a name. If you have many people working on this project, it is good to use a descriptive name so that others can understand, okay, so this insight is about this specific aspect. And you can also send notifications to users when this insight is triggered. And this is where you should provide emails separated by commas. Great. So this is how you can create insights in your GA4 in standard reports. But you can go even a step further and you can do it in the exploration section. So if I go to explore, this is another way to work with anomalies. And let me switch back to the demo account actually, because we have some data here. Let's click freeform and let me delete this town city, not to make it super confusing. And if you click line chart here, you would see something like that. And this is exactly my anomaly detection that I could use. You can see I have my active users as a value. And with this point, it is shown that anomaly is detected. And we can see here that what is expected and what we have. Well, this is interesting that we have this dramatic spike. Okay, but we can also manage our anomaly. And specifically, you have those two slides here and you have something called training period, and it refers to the number of days prior to the selected date range that is used by the anomaly detection model to calculate the expected value of the metric displayed, right? So you can choose this number of days. And then there is also something called sensitivity. So this one sets the probability threshold below which anomalous data will be reported. So the higher the sensitivity, the more outliers you would have. Yeah, so let's put, for example, super high. And here you can see additional points. So now anomaly detected here. Also, the decreases are considered and you can see more. But let's go back and select something in the middle because we need the golden mean. Oh, by the way, virtue is the golden mean between two vices. Do you know who said that? But anyways, coming back to the topic. So this is how you can work with the anomaly, but this is not all. So I can see that I have this considerable spike of my active users, but what can I do with that? So how can I work with it? How can I understand what caused this problem? I could say, I want to look where these users come from. Yeah, right. So how they arrived at my website or application. And I would click plus here and let's look for session source medium because it's not available here. We have to add it, session source medium, and let's click import. Voila. And if you double click, this would be added as a breakdown. So if you want to dive deeper and to drill down into your data, this is exactly where breakdowns come into play. And now we can see, okay, what is happening here? Oh, so we have something called newsletter. So it turned out to be efficient, right? Because you managed to reach so many users. And this is exactly where you could grasp this opportunity. So you can see that it turned out to be quite successful, luckily. This is not a niche at all. This is a good sign. And this is how you can turn this into decisions. Okay, how can I improve my newsletter and make it even better? So maybe I should do more of it because I seem to engage my users. And this is a great opportunity out there. All right, so you can see that you can use breakdowns to dive deeper into the data and to find those specific answers to your questions. Just to sum up, you can work with insights in your reports in the standard reports section, or you could go further and you can have a look at your data in the explore section. And this is where you could work with anomaly detection. You have two slides that you could use for managing it, training period and sensitivity, and you could also use breakdowns to drill down into your data. So now you know how to detect anomaly in GA4, and I hope you will not have any issues, just the opportunities to grasp. And if you like this video, please give a thumbs up, and if you have not done that yet, please hit subscribe right under this video. Happy measuring! See you next time!